हेलो स्टूडेंट, आवर न्यू टॉपिक इज डिस्कवरी ऑफ प्रोटॉन. प्रोटॉन वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय गोल्डस्टीन. एज वी रीड बिफोर, कैथोड रे ट्यूब एक्सपेरिमेंट, सेम एक्सपेरिमेंट वी कैन अप्लाई फॉर द डिस्कवरी ऑफ द प्रोटॉन. बट इन दिस देर इज अ डिफरेंस. वी यूज कैथोड विच इज परफोरेटेड कैथोड. And the one difference is, beside that we use zinc sulfide. Then the question is that why we are using zinc sulfide and perforated cathode? Because when we switch on the battery, then there are 10,000 voltage. And when the current start to go in the circuit, then there is a radiation of electron which allowed to move from cathode to anode, and we give a name, it's a cathode rays. And some particles which are remain there, they are try to move from anode to cathode, and they can pass through these pores and strike to this surface. But sometimes we can't find that they are protons because they can't see. Therefore we are use zinc sulfide here. Whenever any proton strike here, then there is a spark, and when there is a spark, then we can say that there is some particles which are moved from anode to cathode, and they are moving from positive to negative. Therefore it means they have property just like a positive charge, and the direction is from positive to negative. Therefore they are known as canal rays. Hello student, our new topic is discovery of proton. Proton was discovered by Goldstein. As we read before, cathode ray tube experiment, same experiment we can apply for the discovery of the proton. But in this, there is a difference. We use cathode which is perforated cathode. And the one difference is, beside that we use zinc sulfide. Then the question is that why we are using zinc sulfide and perforated cathode? Because when we switch on the battery, then there are 10,000 voltage. And when the current start to go in the circuit, then there is a radiation of electron which allowed to move from cathode to anode, and we give a name, it's a cathode rays. And some particles which are remain there, they are try to move from anode to cathode, and they can pass through these pores and strike to this surface. But sometimes we can't find that they are protons because they can't see. Therefore we are use zinc sulfide here. Whenever any proton strike here, then there is a spark. And when there is a spark, then we can say that there is some particles which are moved from anode to cathode, and they are moving from positive to negative. Therefore it means they have property just like a positive charge, and the direction is from positive to negative. Therefore they are known as canal rays. Before that, electron are known as cathode, and this canal rays is also known as anode. And the next one is, next is that what is the difference between normal cathode and perforated cathode? As we see in this cathode, there are so many pores by which so many protons are passed through that. Therefore by this experiment we can learn that those particles which are moving from positive to negative, they are known as canal rays, and this particle have property just like a positive charge because they are attracting towards the cathode which is negative charge, and those particles which are attracting towards negative, they are always positive, and we give a name which was discovered by Goldstein, and its name is proton. Now we have to read properties of anode rays. First one is anode rays travel in a straight line. As we see for the electron in cathode ray tube experiment, they are moving in a straight line. Similarly, we can say for the proton also, they always move in a straight line. Second one is anode rays are material particle. Next one is anode rays are positively charged, because as we see in the cathode ray tube experiment, they are moving towards negative charge, therefore they are positive particles or positive charge, and they are also known as anode rays or protons, which was discovered by Goldstein. And last one is anode rays may deflected by external magnetic